year in U.S. history. Marco Gonzalez is live with how this is hitting home hard. Marco?
Eben and Lou, with Washington Mutual stocks plummeting, customers feverishly were pulling their deposits, causing this collapse. But now J.P. Morgan, the U.S.'s third largest bank, has stepped in to help the failing bank. But now some WaMu customers have been left with not knowing what to do next.
My first thought was taking my money out and putting it in another bank, and just gonna find out and see if it's something that I need to do.
I actually wasn't that surprised because it's been going on a lot lately, so it didn't really shock me that much.
Earlier today, Washington Mutual stocks took a dive, dropping 25%. Many believe this is what led to J.P. Morgan stepping in.
This is about the deposit, so it's really a cash situation. And I think for all of the depositors, it's something that is a positive, not a negative.
Harvey Green, CEO of real estate investment firm Marcus Millichap, says the way the market is now, this buyout comes as no surprise.
Right now, as you can see, there's a lot of different things occurring in the marketplace. The financial markets are basically in turmoil right now, and really everything is up for grabs, and there's a lot going on in the marketplace that is affecting everything from small depositors to major investors.
To give you an idea of how big J.P. Morgan is, in June, they ended with $722.9 billion in deposits at 3,157 branches. Compare that to Washington Mutual, who had $181.9 billion in deposits at 2,239 branches.
What we're really trying to do, I think, as a government is kind of settle down the financial marketplace and get confidence back in, if you will, our entire equity and capital markets.
But for WaMu customers like Samantha, she says a heads up would have been nice.
I wish there was something that was sent out from the bank letting everybody know exactly what would be taking place.
And it's not uncommon for people to be concerned when their bank is in the headlines, but financial experts, the one we talked to today, said this should be considered a positive thing. Now, this now puts J.P. Morgan at around the same size as Citibank. We're live in Encino tonight. I'm Marco Gonzalez. I'm going to send it back to you in the studio.
Marco, thank you. Earlier today, a crisis meeting at the White House, but tonight, Wall Street's big bailout is in limbo. A Republican revolt stopped the plan in its tracks.
Grant Rampery reporting from the Capitol as negotiators bicker over the bailout, Grant.
Well, Treasury Secretary Hank Paulson had been up here tonight talking to lawmakers on both sides, trying to get them back on track after all the problems today. But late word is those talks have broken up. All sides are far apart, and Democrats are blaming Republicans.
I now expect we will indeed have a plan that can pass the House.
That was early this afternoon. Working toward a compromise bailout deal, as they had been for days, lawmakers appeared to be still somewhat at odds.
But we're very confident that we can act expeditiously.
Then it was over to the White House for a historic gathering with key negotiators, House and Senate leaders, and with the two presidential candidates fresh off the campaign trail.
All of us around the table take this issue very seriously. And we know we've got to get something done as quickly as possible.
Then, an hour into that meeting,
We hadn't gotten an agreement.
A clear sign that it was back to stalemate, or worse. Some nationally recognized economists had told Republicans,
the Paulson plan is a bad plan. It will not solve problems. It will create more problems. We're rushing to judgment.
There never was a deal, but I do believe the meeting was important to move the process along.
John McCain did nothing to help. He only hurt the process.
So their disputes over who's holding things up, how big the bailout package should be, whether it ought to be government funded or privately financed, with the feds providing a kind of insurance policy. That's one of the new wrinkles. For his part, Barack Obama suggests Democrats are in agreement that it's Republicans who need to keep talking to Paulson and the president
to figure out what exactly they want additionally to see to make this thing work.
All sides are set to resume talks tomorrow. As for the big presidential debate, which is set to take place tomorrow night in Mississippi, it's apparently still on. Barack Obama says he'll be there. No firm commitment from John McCain yet. He says he hopes to be. On Capitol Hill, Grant Rampey, KTLA News.
The mere rumors of government bailout led to a big rally on Wall Street. The Dow Jones shot up nearly 200 points after three straight days of closing in the red. But with that bailout now in jeopardy, it's expected that the Dow will be down big tomorrow. Well, they are mad as hell, and they're not going to take it anymore. It's the taxpayers' war cry here in Southern California following the bailout breakdown in Washington. Jim Nash reports live on the bailout backlash. He's in the Fairfax District tonight, the scene of one of those protest rallies. Jim?
Lou, I'll tell you something. These protesters are not alone tonight here in the Fairfax District. We've seen them all day, all over L.A., all over the country. This is a grassroots movement, almost a prairie fire of protest against a bailout that these voters see as a ripoff.
No CEO bailout!
No Bush bailout!
From the Fairfax District,
no Bush bailout,
to Santa Monica, to Pasadena, to Hollywood, protesters denouncing a bailout for Wall Street, joining dozens of similar protests in cities across the U.S., and thousands more on the blogs.
We don't have the money for this. I feel just so overwhelmed by being asked to hold the tab on this.
These spontaneous protests appear to be relatively nonpartisan, based more on taxpayer outrage than on political organization.
I'm a former Republican turned independent and voting libertarian.
But they're united.